Okay. So, ayan, week 9 na tayo. In second order linear differential equation. So, part 3 na siya. Part 3 na yung discussion natin. Kung yung first part is about sa homogeneous, ito is continuation lang ng non-homogeneous. Where we have yung second derivative, ito, which is A times the second derivative plus B times the first derivative plus CY is equal to F of X. Okay, so dito, for the discussion for today, magbibigay ako ng 4 problems and iisa-isahin natin yung working problems na yun. For this problem, we have yung sample problem number 1, which is we need to solve the differential equation. We have here the 2 times the second derivative plus 3 multiplied by the first derivative minus 5y equals a c sine 2x. Kung yung mga previous natin na mga problem is wala pa siyang mga trigonometric function. For this day naman, i-discuss natin is meron na siyang sine and application ng cosine. And syempre, dapat familiar ka na din kung paano tayo magde-derive kapag meron na tayo sa problem na given na we have the sine and cosine. Pero since same lang naman to and continuation lang siya sa second order linear differential equation natin. Same lang siya na dapat malaman natin yung D operator form. Kailangan din natin malaman yung value ng M, value ng function of U, and yung value ng function of V. Okay, for this problem, we have again, itong problem na to, which is we have the 2 times the second derivative plus 3 times the first derivative minus 5y equals the 6 sine 2x. So, ang first natin, same with yung dun sa mga other problems natin, is kailangan natin makuha yung D operator form. For this problem, we have yung D operator form as 2d squared plus 3d times minus 5 times yung y is equal to dun 6 sine 2x natin. And after nun, after natin makuha yung D operator form niya, kailangan natin kunin yung auxiliary equation where we need to sa palitan natin yung D natin as yung M natin. So for the auxiliary equation, we have the 2m squared plus 3m minus 5 is equal to 0. And then after nun, same lang din naman sa previous natin na mga problems, we need to factor out yung itong equation natin na auxiliary equation natin. So we have here the m minus 1 and 2m plus 5. And then after nun, kukunin natin yung value ng m natin. So we have yung first natin na value ng m for the m minus 1 is we have the m equals 1. And for the 2m plus 1, we have the m is equal to negative 5 over 2. Wherein yung m natin na to is pareho naman siyang real number and differential. So babalik lang tayo dun sa category. Hanapin lang natin yung category na we have real and different. So we have here the y is equal to ae raised to alpha x plus be raised to beta x. So papalitan lang natin yung value natin ng alpha and beta, wherein yung alpha natin is yung m natin na 1 and we have yung beta natin as negative 5 over 2. So for the function of cf, for the function of u or yung cf natin, we have the u is equal to a e raised to x plus b e raised to negative 2x. We have na nga yung sa cf natin or yung function of u natin. So kailangan na natin kunin yung value ng or yung v natin or yung function of v natin or yung pi. Ayan. Since same lang nga dun sa dati natin mga discussion, we have here yung table. So dun sa table, madedetermine natin saan ba siyang category papasok. So we have here yung let yung pi natin is equal sa, yung v natin is equal sa a sine 2x plus b cosine 2x. And then same lang, kailangan natin i-substitute itong value ni v sa mismong equation natin, which is we have here yung substituting ng a sine 2x plus b cosine 2x sa 2d squared plus 3d minus ng v. So ito yung minus 5, ito yung v natin. So ito, papalitan na natin siya ng value. And then yung a sine 2x plus b cosine 2x, imamultiply natin siya sa 2d squared, sa 3d, at sa negative 5. So kailangan natin ditong kunin yung second derivative at yung first derivative natin, which is yung d is yung first derivative and yung d squared natin is yung second derivative natin. Okay, for the first derivative, let us recall lang naman. So we have here for the first derivative daw, we have the a sine 2x plus b cosine 2x. So kailangan natin malaman. So kailangan natin malaman ano ba yung derivative ng a sine 2x. So kailangan ma-derive natin yung may sine. And ito naman is we have yung b cosine 2x, kailangan din natin siyang ma-derive. So recall lang siya, we have yung before for the differential calculus nyo na kapag nag-derive tayo, let's say we have the d over dx sine x, is equivalent siya sa cosine x. And kapag naman yung cosine yung nawawala or yung d over dx cosine x, we have the negative sine x. For this problem, so ide-derive natin yung a sine 2x, so ide-derive pa natin itong mismong value natin ng 2x as we have the 2 and we have yung derivative ng sine natin, sine 2x is we have the positive, or we have here for the a sine 2x, we have the 2a cosine 2x. Well, for the b cosine 2x, so same lang siya, so derivation ng 2x is positive lang or yung constant value natin, which is yung 2. And yung derivative ng cosine is we have the negative sine x. Kaya tayo nagkaroon dito ng negative 2b sine 2x. Okay, for the second derivative naman, since nakuha na natin yung first derivative natin, ito naman yung ide-derive natin. Ide-derive natin yung 2a cosine 2x minus 2b sine 2x. Same lang siya. So we have here the cosine. And ang equivalent ng cosine is sine. And for the sine naman, for the sine is cosine naman siya. So for the derivative ng 2a cosine 2x, so we have again yung 2x natin as 2. So we have 2 dito. Kaya magkakaroon tayo ng negative 4 kasi negative sine x ang equivalent ng cosine x. So we have here the negative 4a sine 2x. And then for the 2b sine 2x, same lang siya, i-derive natin first is yung, we have yung 2x as 2. So kaya tayo dito nagkaroon ng 2 times 2, nagkaroon tayo ng 4. And we have yung equivalent ng sine as cosine. So we have here the minus 4b cosine 2x. Yun. So we have the first derivative and second derivative. Papalitan lang natin yung value niya. So we have here as yung sabi nga natin, i-multiply natin yung 2d squared plus 3d minus 5 sa a sine 2x plus b cosine 2x. So ito na yung long term niya, which is nakuha na natin yung sa derivative natin ng second. Tsaka yung first, we have yung negative 8a cosine 2x minus 8b cosine 2x plus 6a cosine 2x minus yung 6b sine 2x minus 5a sine 2x minus 5b cosine 2x is equal dun sa 6 sine 2x. So dito, itong buo na to is yung first derivative natin naka-multiply na siya. I mean, yung second derivative natin is naka-multiply na siya sa 2 while yung first derivative natin is naka-multiply na siya sa 5. And itong 5 na to, naka-multiply na rin siya dito sa a sine 2x plus b cosine 2x. Okay, after daw natin makuha yan, kukunin natin yung, i-equate natin yung coefficient of sine 2x. So alin ba dito yung may mga sine 2x? We have here yung itong negative 8a sine 2x. And we also have yung 6b sine 2x at we have also the negative or minus 5a sine 2x. Simplify lang natin siya. So alin ba dyan yung meron? So we have both naman to is a. So pagsasamahin naman natin siya. We have the negative 13 minus yung b natin, which is we have the negative 6b. And also yung other side, we have the 6 sine 2x, which is equivalent sa 6 lang. So for equating the coefficient of sine 2x, we have the negative 13a minus 6b is equal to 6. And then for equating naman ng cosine 2x natin, babalik lang tayo dun sa problem natin, we have naman dito sa problem again natin, we have yung 8b cosine 2x plus 6a cosine 2x. And then we also have here the minus b cosine 2x. And then for the other side or the right hand side, we have 0 naman siya sa cosine natin, cosine 2x. So therefore, in equating the coefficients of 2 of cosine 2x, we have the 6a minus 13b is equal to 0. And then next natin na step So, itong next step natin, so nag-multiply lang tayo ng 6 at saka ng 13. Based dun sa equation natin from 1 and yung 2 natin. Para makancel natin yung value ni A. Kapag nakancel na natin yung value ni A, makukuha na natin yung value ni itong part na to, makancel na natin siya. Since meron naman siya negative 78A and we have the positive 78A. And then, i-add nga natin itong part na to, which is yung 3 and 4 natin. Kaya cancel na siya. Makukuha na natin yung value natin for B. So we have here for adding the equation 3 and adding the equation 4, we have the negative 200B. And i-divide lang natin siya both side by 200 negative 200B, 205. So we have yung value ng B, which is we have the negative 36 over the 205. And since meron na tayong value ni B, pwede na din natin makuha yung value ni A either sa equation 1 or equation 2 natin. For this problem, ayun, substitute lang natin yung value ni B sa equation natin ng 1 or 2. Kaya makukuha natin yung value ni A as negative 78 over 205. So therefore, ang value natin ng PI is we have the V is equal to negative 78 over the 205 multiplied by sine 2x minus 36 over 205 cosine 2x. And for the general solution, which is yung ginagamit natin for the general solution is Y is equal to U plus V, we have Y is equal to A e raised to X plus B e raised to negative 5 over 2X minus 2 over 205 multiplied by 39 sine 2X plus 18 cosine 2X. Okay, for the sample problem number 2. So, same lang. Okay naman sa pattern natin, so mga previous pattern natin, ngayon is puro cosine and sine lang kasi yung topic natin. So for the problem number 2, we have we need to solve the second derivative plus 16y is equal to 10 cosine 4x, and we have also the given, which is y is equal to 3, and yung dy over dx natin or yung first derivative natin na equals to 4, and when we also have the x is equal to 0. So same lang ng process natin. Kailangan natin munang kunin yung D operator form. Okay, for this problem, we have yung D operator form as D squared plus 16y. 16 times ng y natin is equal to 10 cosine 4x. And then for this problem, kailangan ulit natin kunin yung auxiliary equation natin. For the auxiliary equation natin, we have the m squared plus 16 is equal to 0. So since itong problem natin na to is pwede natin siyang gamitan ng quadratic equation para makuha natin itong value from getting sa quadratic equation, we have yung m is equal to square root ng negative 16 plus minus j4. Kaya may j siya dito is yung sa value na yun, so possible value. So dito, kung babalikan natin yung category natin, category number 3 na to, where ganito yung mismo makukuha yung roots. Ganito yung makukuha ang roots. And yung value natin is we have yung roots natin is complex. Ganito nga kasi hindi naman natin siya na-categorize as same yung roots natin, yung letter M natin. And hindi rin naman natin siya na-categorize as different. So yung CF natin, we have yung U is equal to E raised to 0 multiplied by A cosine 4X plus B sine 4X. So for this problem, since ang e natin is equivalent, e raised to 0 is equivalent sa 1, so we have yung value ng u as a cosine 4x plus b sine 4x. Okay. And then after nun, kukunin ulit natin yung sa table. So we have naman na yung value ni u, yung v naman yung hahanapin natin. Sa table 51.1d natin daw, for we have yung snug case. We have here yung V is equal to X multiplied by C sine 4X plus D cosine 4X. So ito ulit, yung value natin na nabigay doon is babalik lang tayo din sa D operator form natin, which is we have yung D squared plus 16 na mamultiply sa V is equal to 10 cosine 4X. So yung value ni V, papalitan ulit natin yung value ni V. Ang value ni V ay X C sine 4X plus D cosine 4X. So ito na nga yan. So, multiply natin siya sa d squared or yung sa value natin ng second derivative and yung sa 16. So bago natin makuha yung second derivative, kailangan pa rin natin kunin si first derivative tsaka pa lang tayo makakuha ng second derivative. Okay, for this problem naman, since ito nga, kukunin muna natin si first derivative, recall lang ulit natin yung product rule. Since we have naman dito yung x na imumultiply sa c sine 4x plus d cosine 4x. So for the product rule ulit, yung formula natin for the product rule is we have the d over the dx multiplied dun sa u and v natin. So for this problem, ang u natin is yung x and yung v natin is c sine 4x plus d cosine 4x. So sa formula, we need to get first yung u, na identify natin si u, and ide-derive naman natin yung value ni v plus yung v natin and ide-derive natin si u. Okay. For this problem, sabi natin yung u natin is si x. And then derivation daw nitong value natin na to. Itong c sine 4x plus cosine 4x. So same lang kanina, na-recall naman natin yung formula or derivation for the sine and cosine. So for the derivation of c sine 4x, we have naman here yung derivative ng 4x is 4 and yung derivative ng sine 4x is cosine 4x. So therefore, ang derivative ng c sine 4x is 4c cosine 4x. And then for the d cosine 4x, derivative ng 4x is 4. And for the derivative ng cosine 4x is negative sine 4x. So we have here for the derivative of d cosine 4x, we have the negative minus 4d sine 4x. Okay. And next natin, sabi natin, plus yung v natin. So we have here as v is c sine 4x plus d cosine 4x. And yung last natin is imumultiply daw siya sa derivative ng u. Yung derivative ng x is 1. Okay. So therefore, ito yung buong first derivative natin. And kukunin daw natin yung second derivative natin. Sa second derivative, same lang din naman siya based dito sa mismong problem natin. And we have here yung x minus 16. Ito yung nakasimplified based dito sa first derivative natin. So we have the x multiplied by the negative 16c sine 4x minus the 16d cosine 4x. So for this problem, kunin lang natin yung second derivative natin. And same lang siya as dun sa product rule natin. So ayan, we have the 4c cosine 4x minus 4d sine 4x plus yung 4c cosine 4x plus 4d sine 4x. Okay, for this problem, since nakuha na naman natin yung value ng second derivative, we have here yung naka-expand na siya. We have the negative 16c cx sine 4x minus the 16 dx cosine 4x plus cosine c cosine 4x minus the 4d sine 4x plus 4c cosine 4x minus the 4d sine 4x. And itong part na to, ito na yung minultiply sa 16. Kaya tayo merong 16 cx sine 4x plus 16 dx cosine 4x. And yung right hand side natin, which is we have the 10 cosine 4x. Okay, for this problem naman, same lang siya. So we need to equate naman, same kanina na nag-equate tayo ng sine and cosine. So if we will going to equate the coefficients of cosine 4x, we have naman dun sa problem na 8c kasi ito, 8c cosine 4x and yung 10 cosine 4x natin. So pwede na natin makuha yung value natin ng c if we will going to divide it both sides sa 8. Therefore, we have yung C as value ng 10 over 8 or equivalent siya sa 5 over 4. And if we will also equate the coefficient using yung sine 4x naman natin, sa sine 4x, we have yung value natin as negative d sine 4x. Sa right-hand side natin is wala naman siya. So we have here the negative d is equal to 0. So kapag dinivide natin siya both side by negative 8, the value of d is 0 pa rin siya. Okay. So therefore, ang value natin for the PI is equal to yung V natin is equal sa X multiplied by 5 over 4 sine 4X. And kapag kukunin natin yung general solution, we have the Y is equal to U plus v natin. So kapag in-expand natin to, we have the y is equal to a cosine 4x plus b sine 4x plus 5 over 4x multiplied by sine 4x. Okay, next natin. Meron pa tayo itong category na binigay natin na value, yung x natin, yung y natin, and then yung first derivative natin. Papalitan lang natin yung value natin, yung x natin is magiging 0 and yung y natin is magiging 3. So therefore, we have here the 3 is equal to a cosine 0 plus yung b sine 0 natin plus yung 0. So pwede na natin makuha yung value natin as yung a natin is equivalent sa 3. Okay, for the dy over dx naman, we have yung negative 4a sine 4x plus yung b 4b cosine 4x. So, plus yung 5 over 4x multiplied dun sa 4 cosine 4x natin plus 5 over 4 sine 4x natin. So, if we have yung value as yung x natin is equal to 0 and yung value natin na sabi is we have the 4 as yung first derivative natin, we have here the 4 is equal to negative 4a sine 0 plus yung 4b cosine 0 plus yung 0 plus 5 over 4 sine 0. Therefore, pwede na natin makuha yung value natin ng b natin. As 4 is equal to 4b, so di-divide lang natin both sides sa 4. Therefore, we have yung value as b as 1. So yung particular solution natin for this problem, we have the y is equal to 3 cosine 4x plus sine 4x plus 5 over 4x sine 4x. For the sample problem number 3, so same lang siya ng problem natin, again. Pero ang given naman natin for the right-hand side is we have the sine x. So, solve the problem. For number 3, we have the solve the equation. We have the second derivative plus the first derivative minus 6y is equal to 12x minus 50 sine x. Okay, same lang siya. So, kukunin ulit natin yung d operator for. For this problem, we have yung d squared for the second derivative, d for the first derivative, and then yung minus 6 natin multiplied by y is equal to 12x minus 50 sine x. And kukunin lang ulit natin yung auxiliary equation. We have here the m squared plus m minus 6 is equal to 0. And then since kukunin naman natin based dito sa auxiliary equation yung value ng m, pag-factor muna natin siya, we have dun sa pag-factor natin as m minus 2 at m plus 3. And kukunin natin yung value ni m. For the m minus 2, we have the m is equal to 2. And for the m plus 4, we have the m is equal to negative 3. And then after nyan, hanapin natin siya doon sa table natin. And then we have the right-hand side as the differential polynomial na siya. So we have yung pi, value natin ng v is equal to ax plus b plus c sine x plus d cosine x. Okay, for dito naman, isa-substitute ulit natin yung value ng v natin, which is we have yung itong value na to. Therefore, we have yung d squared plus d minus c, 6 minus 6, multiplied by the ax plus b plus c sine x plus yung d cosine x natin is equal to dun sa 12x minus 50 sine x. And same lang sa mga previous natin na problems, kailangan natin kunin yung first derivative for the d and second derivative for the d squared. So for the first derivative, kailangan natin kunin yung first derivative ng ax plus b plus c sine x plus d cosine x. Recall lang, if we have yung sa differentiate natin or kunin natin yung derivative ng constant value, equivalent lang siya sa 0. Kapag naman kukuhanin natin yung derivative ng sine x, we have yung cosine x. If we will going to get the derivative of cosine x, we have the negative sine x. And kapag yung value naman natin is we have yung cosine, yung constant value na i-multiply sa x natin. So, yung value lang niya is yung constant value natin. Okay, for this problem, we have yung ax. Ang derivative ng ax is a lang. And for the derivative of b is equivalent sa 0. For the derivative of c sine x, we have the c cosine x. And for the derivative of d cosine x is equivalent lang din to sa d sine x. And after nun, dahil kailangan nga din natin kunin yung second derivative, we have here for the second derivative, iti-derive lang natin based dun sa first derivative natin. So for the second derivative, we have yung a as a, yung a natin is derivative niya is zero na lang din, so wala na siya sa second derivative. And for the c cosine x, we have the negative c sine x. And for the derivative naman ng d sine x, we have the minus d cosine x. And same lang siya, so makukuha na natin yung first derivative and first derivative. Expand lang natin siya. We have here the negative c sine x minus d cosine x plus the first derivative. We have the a plus c cosine x minus d sine x. And yung multiply natin yung negative 6 sa ax plus b plus c sine x plus d cosine x, and yung right hand side natin na 12x minus 50 sine x. And kapag kukunin daw natin yung constant terms, we have here the value of a is equal to 6b is equal to 0. Based lang siya dito sa problem natin. And yun nga, equate natin yung coefficient of x. We have naman yung value as 6. Negative 6a is equal to 12. And from this naman, pwede na natin makuha yung value ng a. I-divide lang natin siya both side by negative 6. So we have the value of a as equal siya sa negative 2. And then from dun sa equation natin, from dun sa first equation natin, which is yung first equation natin, is we have the a minus 6b is equal to 0. May value na tayo ni a. So sa substitute lang natin dito yung value ni a, makukuha na rin natin yung value ni b. Kapag sinubstitute natin yung value ni a dun sa equation 1 natin, makukuha natin yung value ni b as negative 1 over 3, or we have the negative 1/3. And then after nun, kukunin ulit natin yung coefficient ng cosine x and yung sine x natin. So for the coefficient of x, cosine x, babalik lang tayo din sa equation natin, itong equation na to. So hahanapin lang natin dito lahat ng value natin na meron tayong cosine x. So we have here the negative d cosine x. We also have the c cosine x. And dito is we have yung d cosine x na dapat imultiply siya sa 6. And for the right hand side, wala naman tayong cosine x. So therefore, for the coefficients of cosine x, we have the negative d plus c minus 6d is equal to 0. And then simplify lang natin, since we have both d naman dito, we have the c minus 7d is equal to 0. And same lang sa coefficient of x naman, sine x, balik lang ulit tayo dun sa problem natin. For this problem, we have naman yung negative c sine x. And we also have yung next natin as negative d sine x. And we have yung c sine x na dapat imultiply sa 6. And for the right hand side, we have the negative 50 or minus 50 sine x. And simplify lang natin, we have the minus c minus d minus 6c is equal to negative 50. And here, i-combine lang natin yung both natin na c, we have the negative c, 7c minus d is equal to negative 50. Okay, para man makuha natin yung value ni c at yung value ni d, i-solve lang natin yung equation natin. Ito yung equation natin ng number 2, which is we have yung c minus 7d is equal to 0, and yung equation natin ni 3 na we have the negative 7c minus d is equal to negative 50. So kapag naman in-equate na natin siya pareho, pwede na natin makuha yung value ng c at yung d natin. So we have here as yung value natin ng c as 7, and yung value natin ng d as 1. And therefore, yung value natin for the PI is we have the v is equal to negative 2x minus yung 1/3 plus 7 sine x natin plus cosine x. And then, kukunin lang natin ulit yung value ng y is equal to u plus v. Yung y natin for the general solution, we have the y is equal to ae raised to 2x plus be raised to negative 3x minus yung v natin na 2x minus 1 third plus 7 sine x plus cosine x. Okay, for the last problem naman natin, same lang siya sa problem natin ng number 2 na meron tayong value ng x and y and also yung first derivative natin. So for the sample problem number 4, we have here solve the equation second derivative minus 2 times the first derivative plus 2y is equal to 3e raised to x. cosine 2x. So given natin na yung x natin is equivalent to 0, yung y natin is 2, and yung first derivative natin is 3. Okay, for this problem, same lang siya sa previous again. Kunin natin yung D operator form, kunin natin yung auxiliary equation. After natin kunin yung auxiliary equation, magfa-factor out tayo, either gamitin natin yung quadratic equation, basta makuha natin yung value ni M. Okay? For this problem daw, we have yung D for the D operator form. For the second derivative, we have the D squared. For the 2 times the first derivative, we have the negative 2D. And for the 2, equivalent lang siya plus yung 2. And we have here the 3e raised to x cosine 2x. And kukunin lang natin yung auxiliary equation where we have the m squared minus 2m plus 2 is equal to 0. And for this problem, yung m squared minus 2m plus 2, if a factor out natin siya, so yung best way dito sa problem is gagamit tayo ng quadratic equation. Okay, recall lang for the quadratic equation, ito yung formula natin for the quadratic equation. We have the x is equal to negative b plus minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over the 2a. So yung a natin dito is itong for the m squared natin or yung 1. And for the b natin is we have yung negative 2m or yung negative 2 natin. And yung c natin is yung 2. Okay, so substitute lang natin yung value. For this problem, we have yung m is equal to 2 plus minus the square root of 4. 4 is yung naka-squared na yung 2 natin, minus 4. A natin is 1 and 2 natin is yung c over the 2. And ang value natin for this problem is we have yung, since hindi natin makukuha itong square root na to, so we have the 2 plus minus j2 over the 2. Therefore, yung m natin is equivalent sa 1 over 1 plus minus j1. Sinimplify lang itong value ng 2 plus minus j2 over the 2. Kaya naging siya 1 plus minus j1. Yun yung for the value of m natin. And since after nito, kapag daw nakuha natin yung value ng m natin, ika-categorize natin siya based doon sa value natin. Kung real ba siya? Real and same yung value ng m. Real and different yung value ni m, or same lang dito sa value natin na hindi siya nakakategorize as same or different. So for the category natin as complex, ito daw yung for the CF natin. We have yung CF as u is equal to e raised to x multiplied by the a cosine x plus b sine x. Okay. And after nito, since nakuha naman natin yung value natin for the function natin, o function of u or yung CF natin, kukunin naman natin yung value ng v or yung function ng v natin or yung pi natin. Same lang before, hanapin natin siya dun sa table 51.1. Ang value daw for this, for the product of an exponential and cosine function, we have yung v as e raised to x multiplied by c sine 2x plus d cosine 2x na nasa table naman natin na nagkakategorize na we have yung constant c and d are used since a and b have already been used for the CF. Okay. Yung CF natin is yung function of u, which is yung itong value na to. So yun. So papalitan natin yung value natin ng v. We have here as d squared minus 2d plus yung 2 natin, multiply din sa value ng v natin. Yung value ng v natin is e raised to x, c sine 2x plus d cosine 2x natin. And yung right-hand side natin, which is we have the 3e raised to x cosine 2x. Then same lang siya sa problem natin, yung problem natin ng kanina, which is we need to determine naman yung sa product rule ng first derivative and yung second derivative natin. So for the first derivative natin, kailangan natin ma-determine ano ba yung value ni u at yung value ni v. Kasi ang product rule natin, sabi natin kanina, yung u i-multiply sa v or yung differential equation niya, we need to determine yung u, yung value ng derivative ng v plus yung v natin, and then yung multiply sa derivative ng u natin. So for this problem, ang first derivative, ang u natin is yung e raised to x. And for the derivative natin, ang value ng v natin is we have yung 2 cosine 2x minus the 2d sine 2x. Okay, so expand lang natin siya. We have here yung e2c plus yung d cosine 2x. Kailangan lang natin ma-derive yung value plus yung c minus 2d sine 2x natin. And then for the second derivative, from dun sa first derivative natin, kailangan pa rin natin ditong kunin yung power rule natin, where we have yung value ng u is yung e raised to x, and yung v natin is yung minus 4c sine 2x minus 4d cosine 2x. And simplify lang natin siya, we have the e raised to x multiplied dun sa negative 3c minus 4d sine 2x plus 4c minus 3d cosine 2x. So kapag nakuha natin yung first derivative at saka yung second derivative natin using the power rule, babalik ulit tayo dun sa problem natin. So ito yung problem natin kanina. We have the d squared minus 2d plus 2 na minultiply sa v natin. So yung for the value of d squared, we have here yung sa value na e raised to x multiplied by negative 3c plus 4d sine 2x plus the 4c minus 3d cosine 2x minus na yung 2e raised to x 2c plus d cosine 2x plus yung c natin minus 2d sine 2x plus ito na yung sa part natin ng sa last natin, ito yung sa second first derivative, ito na yung sa 2 natin na nakamultiply. So we have the 2 e raised to x multiplied by c sine 2x plus d cosine 2x is equal dun sa right hand side natin na 3e raised to x multiplied by the cosine 2x. And after nyan, kailangan natin makuha ulit yung value natin ng coefficient. Okay, for this problem, yung first natin, same lang siya dun sa problem na ikukunin natin yung coefficient ng sine and cosine. But for this problem, yung coefficient na kukunin natin is we have yung e raised to x sine 2x. So pag binalikan natin yung problem natin, which is itong problem natin na to, hahanapin natin yung meron tayong value ng e raised to x sine 2x. Dun daw sa itong equation na to, we have daw yung minus 3c minus 4d minus 2c plus 4d plus 2c natin. And sa right-hand side is wala, kaya siya 0. And for this problem, pwede na natin i-cancel yung value natin ng d. And pwede natin tayo mag-add. Since naman naka negative 4d and positive 4d na to, so equivalent lang to as 0. And for this, we have naman yung minus 3c, minus 2c, and yung positive 2c. So itong plus 2c at saka yung minus 2c, equivalent na rin siya sa 0 na to. So we have here the negative 3c is equal to 0. And i-divide natin by negative 3 both sides, we have the value of c as 0. And next naman natin, sabi natin, is kukunin naman natin yung coefficient ng ex cosine 2x. Ibabalik lang ulit tayo dito sa problem natin na to. For this problem, hanapin lang natin yung meron tayong e raised to x and we have the cosine 2x. For this problem daw, we have the minus 4c minus 3d minus the 4c minus the 2d plus 2d and equal siya sa 3 natin. And simplify lang ulit natin yung problem na to. So for the C, we have the 4C and minus 4C. Pwede na natin itong i-cancel since equivalent naman siya sa 0. And for the plus 2D and minus 2D, kapag in-add naman natin siya, is equivalent na rin to sa 0. So we have here na lang yung negative 3D and yung 3 natin. And divide natin both side by negative 3D, negative 3 lang, both side by negative 3, makukuha natin yung value natin ng D as negative 1. Okay, for this problem, yung given natin na value for the PI, we have the V is equal to e raised to x multiplied by the negative cosine 2x. So, yun na yung value ng V natin. For the general solution naman natin, we have for the general solution as yung y is equal to e raised to x multiplied by the a cosine x plus b sine x. Ito yung for the function of u. And for the V natin, we have the negative or the minus e raised to x cosine 2x. And then, hindi lang dito pa siya nagtatapos yung problem natin kasi meron tayong binigay kanina na value ng x natin, value ng y, and yung value ng first derivative natin. So, papalitan lang natin ulit or gagamitan natin yung value natin where we have the value of x is equal to 0 and yung value natin ni y as equivalent sa 2. So, substitute lang natin siya dun sa problem natin. So, ito siya or yung equation natin. So we have here as yung 2, yung y natin, and yung 0, yung x natin. So 2 is equal to e raised to 0 multiplied by the value of a cosine 0 plus b sine 0 minus the e raised to 0 cosine 0. So we have here the value of 2 is equal to a minus yung 1 natin na value. So for this problem, itatransfer lang natin yung value ni 1 sa other side. Itong value ni 1, kaya tayo magkakaroon ng value ng a natin as equivalent sa 3. And gagamitin naman natin yung value ng first derivative dy over dx is equal to e raised to x multiplied by the minus a sine x plus b cosine x plus e raised to x multiplied by the a cosine x plus b sine x minus the e raised to x multiplied by minus 2 sine x plus e raised to x cosine 2x. So we have naman yung value natin, yung value ng x is equal to 0 at saka yung derivative natin ng 3. So yun yung papalit natin dito ng value. So we have the 3 is equal dun sa value natin kanina, yung naka-long term siya. So, substitute lang natin. So, therefore, we have the 3 is equal to e raised to 0 minus a sine 0 plus b cosine 0 plus e raised to 0 multiplied by a cosine 0 b sine 0 minus the e raised to 0 multiplied by minus 2 sine 0 minus e raised to 0 cosine 0. Makukuha na natin yung value natin based dito. Since yung e raised to 0 naman natin is equivalent sa 1, so we have here that 3 is equal to sine, 3 is equal to b plus a minus 1. And from this equation, makukuha natin yung value natin as kanina may value na tayo ng a natin. So yung value daw natin kanina before ng a is 3. So itong 3 na to is isa-substitute lang natin dito sa equation natin. So kapag sinubstitute natin, we have the 3 is equal to b plus 3 minus 1. Makukuha natin yung value natin ng b as equal siya sa 1. So therefore, yung particular solution natin is equivalent sa y is equal to e raised to x, 3 cosine x plus sine x minus e raised to x cosine 2x.